Hi, Shining Soul. Today I am showing you the Lumina Tarot. Let your intuition guide you. This deck has recently been published by Rockpool Publishing. The date was September 24th this year. I am so hyped about it. I wanted to buy a new tarot deck for some time now, but I didn't find the one where I felt drawn to. And when I saw this one, it was an immediate connection when I was looking at the pictures, and I'm so stoked about this deck. Before I dive into it, this is your reminder that I unbox tarot decks the way that we will flip through the cards, then the guidebook, and at the end you get a mini pick a card, and then I will read the description in the guidebook. The publisher says about this deck, "The universe is alive and listening. When you take time to intentionally connect and play with this deck, the universe is ready to work with and through you, guiding and supporting you with the answers you've been seeking. Lumina Tarot is a tool for you to access the places in yourself that are at times hard to reach. It's not so much a divination tool as it is a mirror offering self-exploration, reflection, and confirmation. Lumina Tarot invites you to see yourself in new ways, calling you to come back into your own knowing when you can feel the stirrings of your soul's essence guiding you forward. Let go of your judgments and preconceived ideas. Move into the waters of your natural intuitive ability. Lean into this feeling, for it's from this place that you are able to unfold your own mystery. This isn't a tarot deck that tells you who you are. Rather, it will inspire you to believe in yourself and be the hero of your own life." This is totally up my alley and the way how I personally read tarot. I already showed you how beautiful this box is with all the holographic elements here. It goes even further to the side, and on the back you have a little overview and the subtitle, "Shine a light on your inner self." I do have to say, I have big hands. This is the box. I hate that it is this big. But now let's have a look inside. Okay, this is beautiful. We have the guidebook here. This is thick. The pages are so glossy. We look at the guidebook later. First, the cards. And yes, the edges are holographic as well. Look at this. It is so pretty. Thankfully, the box does not indicate the size of the cards. These are very much normal-sized cards, so no need to worry if you have a little bit smaller hands, you will absolutely be able to shuffle them. Now let's go for the cards themselves. The camera has a hard time picking the color up, but the backside has a beautiful pastel pattern. This way you can see it a little bit better. Like the rainbow pastels are here, and it's stunning. And then you have swords, cups, and the snakes are building a ring which can be seen for pentacles, sure, and you have wands here. So you have the suits. No, here are the pentacles. So you have the suits on the back. Okay. And I'm just in love with these edges. Jesus Christ, they are so stunning. They are not super thick, but they feel, they have like a matte finish, and they feel amazing in the hand. And They will shuffle super well. Starting with the Fool, of course. We have a very carefree girl here with a doe next to her and butterflies. And again, those beautiful rainbow colors. The Magician has again the symbol for every suit here and is levitating them basically, or juggling them, or like both. The card is very impressive. I love this. Then you have the High Priestess. This is a unique way to show this card. It again plays with the topic of being a mirror and mirroring things. Beautiful. I love that it's a little bit of an older woman. That does make sense in my hand. Oh my god, the Empress, the Bee Queen. So pretty. And right away we have the Emperor. Yes, definitely fitting vibes. I love how they mirror in which hands they are holding their staff. Very pretty. I'm not sure the camera is picking this up correctly. It's a dark blue in the background here for the Emperor. Makes it stand out a lot. The Hierophant has guru vibes here. That is so pretty. So well made, like the lighter background where the colorful center is. Stunning. The Lovers. That is a choice that's not obvious at first. We have two wolves chasing each other, but it does make sense in the shadow work way to read tarot, so I'm totally here for it. The Chariot has the horses, but not the wagon. I love this. There's so much speed and movement in this card. It's beautiful. Justice, Libra. On the edge of a sword, holding the scales blindfolded. Beautiful interpretation. The Hermit in a desert setting. Beautiful. I am so in love with the art of this deck. I cannot even say. This is one of the best interpretations of the wheel I've seen in ages. Like, you have every phase of the moon, and you have those arms and the connection of the earth with the hidden realm. Like, the symbols here are chef's kiss. Strength is a classic. I do like the color choice here. The Hanged Man on a cliff or between two cliffs and then hanging there. Nice. The Death card is very on the nose and also not. This gives me just Memento Mori vibes. And I'm here for it. With the rose and the snake. It's stunning. Temperance. The Devil is the only card I don't really get from the symbols. The Bison is vanishing here. The Tower is one of my favorite cards in this deck. I should not say that, but it is. Look how beautiful this is. It's a pile of stones and lightning strikes it and a raven is flying away from the tower, from the collapsing tower. It's just so powerful, and you see how long the foundation of the pile was building, because you have all the mushrooms here, some on top of the stones here. It's just so stunning. The star is simple but on point. I like this. And I have a crush on this person. How beautiful is the drawing of this person here? Like, chef's kiss. I love this moon card. It's one of the prettiest I've ever seen. And then we have the sun here. The judgment card is again a little bit more of an abstract choice. And so is the world. We have the moth. And here a bunch of flowers in the bottom. Ace of Wands. A classic wand. There's nothing I can say here. Two of Wands. You see runes here. And again, all those hidden symbolism and geometric figures. Just beautiful. Three of Wands. The eye in the center. The Four of Wands is a crystal grid. I am obsessed with this. It's so pretty. Five, some deers. The six. As above, so below. We have the elements up here. The seven features a beetle. The eight, a lot of illumination. And so has this nine of wands. And the 10 features the fox. It's so cute. And then we have something this deck does different. You do not have a page, you have a maiden. So the maiden of wands also has the fox here. And here's the fox with the knight of wands. This is such an energetic, impressive card. I love it. The queen. The fox is like around her. You see the tail coming up on the left side. And the king has his fox as well, of course. Beautiful. Moving on to the cups, we have the eye again with the ace of cups. Two of cups. I see a bird theme here. Dragonflies for the three. Oh, I like we have the fresh, clean water here and the murky water down here for those cups. The five has the cups connected with a thread and a crow picking at it or holding it together. That is up to interpretation. The six has spider webs between the cups and they are catching flies and butterflies and things. That makes sense for not getting caught up in nostalgia, basically. The seven of cups. Oh, the snake is so impressive here. Connecting all the cups here. Eight of cups. Stunning. Like, this artwork is so beautiful. Nine of cups. And the 10 features butterflies. The maiden of cups is the picture we had at the front of the box. And the snake is the theme here for the cups. We have the Knight of Cups with the snake again. The Queen of Cups. And once again, like the mirroring theme you have here, with the water here and with the Queen mirroring herself. And you have the King of Cups. Yes, they definitely fit together. Moving on to the swords. Impressive. The Two of Swords have... This is an eagle, I think. The classic heartache Three of Swords has the thoughts going through a rose. Very fitting. It's not... It's close, very close to the classic interpretation. A heart, a rose is a heart, love, connection is all there. The Four of Swords. The Five, that features again the Death Moth. The Six of Swords, like with all those hidden swords here, beautiful. The Seven, it's hard to see in the light I have and with the yellows, but the swords are hidden here. The 8, 9, we're going from a mice to a bat, nice, and the 10, that is a little bit graphic, because the red really pops in this card, and then we have the eagle from earlier as a theme for the swords. The braids, and like this is stunning. Okay, this is very acrobatic. Holding the sword with the feet, having the eagle sitting on the knee. Okay, knight. Yes, the queen does totally give queen vibes. There's some fine, very fine lines. And the king, yes, very fitting. Pentacles. I love the contrast here and how the artist is working with the shadow and light in here. Oh, the two is so pretty, like with those, I would say daisies. Then we have the Three, growing, just building the foundation of something. The Four. The Five has a rotten apple, okay. The Six. I love how visible the coins are in all of it. We have a cactus, again with the moon phases on top. The 8. The 9 is like the flower of life, right? And then you have the 10 and a bear and a bee. So which one is it for the current cards? The bear for Pentacles. How cute is this little teddy bear with the maiden? And then we have, ooh, two bears, an adult and a kid one for the night. Also, the Screams Alaska, it's so pretty, like for the landscape. And here we have the queen. And lastly, the king of pentacles. I love all of them. Let's have a quick look at the guidebook before we go over to the pick a card part. As I mentioned earlier, this is very glossy. It feels very high quality. You have the slight pastel rainbow theme going on that you have at the back of the cards. Okay, table of content. Introduction, working with the cards, major arcana, minor arcana, about the author and about the illustrator. So, working with the cards. Get your intuition and internal guidance system, get centered and clear. A tarot journal. New moon and full moon insights, a card a day. Chakra spread, those are pretty spreads in here. And some basic explanations. I like this. This is very beginner friendly as well. It explains the symbolic animal, the fox in here, has the fire signs, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, and has a quick overview about the personality traits. And that for each suit and the connection to the elements. It's also briefly talking about the reversed cards. I like this. This is a beautiful explanation for the tarot cards. For both ways, upright and reversed. Connection. The author is Australian, and let's see. And so is the illustrator. Beautiful. For Tegan, the illustrator, this deck is equal parts love, coffee, and red wine. It was an absolute joy to create. Okay, considering I am love, coffee, and white wine, I do understand why I was drawn to this deck. Okay, let's shuffle. This is where you make your choice and pick a card. Number one, two, or number three. Pause if you need a little moment longer. I will start reading card number one. If you picked number one, the Ace of Wands is your card. Go for it. The Ace of Wands is inspiration and action. This is a card of great creative power, signifying potency. Wands are fiery yang energy, evoking passion, will, vitality, and momentum. You are entering a significantly powerful phase of your life. A new relationship, creative endeavor, profession, study, or business venture will consume your being, igniting you to step towards yourself and embrace the leader within. This is a time to listen to your instinct and potentially bend the rules a little. Trust that the inspired idea coupled with action will grow and develop, allowing you to use new game plans as this endeavor evokes. Trust that the inspired idea coupled with action will grow and develop, allowing you to use new game plans as this endeavor evolves. Take action now. rather than mull on it further. You are being supported by the stars, and it's imperative you work with the energies at play. The Ace of Wands can also signify a groundbreaking aha moment, allowing you to finally see a situation with clarity, especially if you have been lingering in the darkness, feeling uninspired and confused. And the reverse meaning, which does not apply today, but I will still read it, so you get to know the guidebook. You may feel overwhelmed and confused with too many competing ideas in your head to discern which is the most aligned decision. The lack of direction may leave you heavy and unmotivated, especially if there is pressure for you to participate in life in a certain way. The reversed Ace of Wands may also come as an indicator that you are burdened and stifled by responsibility. Perhaps the potential for inspiration and action is there, but you are being blocked by the situation, requiring your full attention and energy. This may be frustrating if you have grown past what is on offer currently. Carve a little space for yourself. There is a path forward. It just requires you to be committed to honoring yourself and the inspiration stirring within. I like this. This is for everyone who picked card number 2, the Maiden of Swords. Fresh starts, new adventures. Your curious and logical mind is forever thinking up fresh ideas and new adventures. Your spirit steers you continually. You crave adventure and vibrancy that reflects who you really are. You hold a lot of plans and ideas for the future, and you're ready to act upon them. Begin to communicate your desires, visions, and theories to those who will support such explorations. Yet, at such a vulnerable and fresh time, be wise who you surround yourself with and to whom you expose your thoughts and ideas. Maiden of Swords can be an energetic, fierce, and aloof creature who possesses a wit that either charms or stings. A wonderful communicator and spokesperson, she is more inclined to be truthful and honest than sneaky and deceitful, yet she is known for both. People seek out the opinion and insight of the Maiden of Swords as her frankness is appreciated. Being naturally gifted at analyzing and understanding and articulating complex ideas makes her a valuable teacher, yet she may lack the wisdom and life experience to relate to and guide others in a deeper and more meaningful way. In the reverse, it's talking. This card may appear reversed to let you know that you have become all talk and no action. As a gifted communicator, you are able to share a vision, articulate information, or stand up for the rights of others. Yet, if there is no actionable substance under your words, soon enough people will see through you. Commit to your word or do not speak at all. Seize opposition just for the momentary challenge and find something that deeply ignites you. You may be overwhelmed by abundance of thoughts and feelings, entranced by many avenues yet unable to decide which to follow. You are adept at using your mind, yet in times like these, it is important to anchor yourself and explore the guidance of your heart. There is no point in becoming frazzled over endeavors that lack meaning for you. And for everyone who picked card number 3, you got the Empress. Flourishing growth. Powerful feminine beauty is pushing up through your fertile inner words, offering warmth and strength. You are assessing the Empress within, a majestic and magical force who thrives on aligned living, grounding, connection and appreciation of the beauty around you. A continual sense of fulfillment energizes you, allowing you to share this wealth with others. Your creations and connections blossom under your fingertips. You have entered a period of creativity, giving you access to parts of yourself and the universe you had only imagined. Observe and explore these dynamics and feminine forces. The Empress is a ruler superior to all queens, an earth mother and goddess. All things spring from her love and kindness. She holds very little physical wealth. Her abundance comes from the respect and reverence of those she serves. Recognize that you already have everything you need. Connect with nature and loved ones and embrace the powerful yin energy within. Explore your own mother energy and the mother energy surrounding you, from your matriarchal line to your kindred sisters and Gaia herself. Reversed, a reversed Empress alludes the disconnection from your personal power and vibrancy due to investing so much of yourself and others, with little rejuvenation emotionally and spiritually. Caring for other people in your life has left you burned out, stunting your creative fire. You may feel exhausted, depressed, frustrated, and bitter. It is time to come back to your core, spend time in nature and in silence, make room for playfulness and sensuality, and find avenues for creative expression. Invite freshness in. A disconnect from yourself may also be due to a sense of something being missing. Continually yearning will only perpetuate and expand this energy of lack and loss. Listening to your inner voice, you are always being guided and supported. Which is a beautiful sentence to close this video with. Please don't forget to subscribe for more content like this and leave a like. And tell me in the comments, what do you think of this deck? See you in the next one.